Hello everyone! Have you ever wondered about what is light?
This daily phenomenon, this mysterious one.
The light is a beam of photons which produce because of the extremely quick transmission of electrons between two loaded poles. When a pole enters into the field of the other pole that has the inverse charge. While photons are tiny, elementary, and infinitesimal particles, of which volume may look like electrons one. The photon has no mass, so it cannot be slowed down by any friction that allows it to move with very high and incomparable speed, the speed of light. Every photon has a wave, yet we can represent light as electromagnetic waves, which are a form of energy that is all around us and takes many forms such as radio waves, microwaves, x-rays, etc., etc. And for our topic, it's light. It's a very small portion of the electromagnetic spectrum. The electromagnetic waves are created when an atomic particle, such as electron, is accelerated by an electric field, causing it to move. The movement produces oscillating electric and magnetic fields which travel at right angles to each other. Once the electromagnetic field, which extends in the universe, is disturbed, we get waves. Just like if we threw a stone in a lake or we move a rope. The electromagnetic waves and photons wave are characterized by the wavelength, which is the distance between peaks. The human eyes are able to detect electromagnetic waves with a wavelength between 400 nanometers and 800 nanometers. How about colors? The light's color depends on the wavelength. The longer it is, the more the color tends to be red. And the shorter it is, the more the color tends to be purple. Between both of them, light adopts rainbow colors. And this is actually how scientists determine the temperature of stars. Finally, let me tell you that everything shows electromagnetic waves, of which level depends on the energy. For instance, if an object is hot, the wavelength is short, and vice versa. I hope that I have been able to try to simplify the discoveries done by some scientists interested by this fact. It was Brahim Anjar from Morocco. Thank you for watching and goodbye.